let's take a look at how we can extract password hashes of macOS and then convert it into the correct formats so we can crack it with hashcat. macOS does this utility called dscl. It stands for Directory Service Command Line Utility, and you can basically use it to query the local directory. In this case, list all the users. You can see here we have, this is my user account, and then we have Alice. So our goal now is to take a look at the password hash of Alice, then convert it so that we can crack it with hashcat. In order to do that, we run dscl again, connect to the local directory service database, and then we do read users Alice. And so let's take a look what that returns. This gives us a lot of information about the account. You can see the creation time, failed login accounts, password, last set. So a lot of interesting information. But further down, if you keep scrolling down, this piece of information, this is what we really want. So it's called ShadowHashData. And so if you run that same command again and just specify that piece of information, you just get that back. And let's pipe that to ls.hashData. Okay. So notice this first line, we have to remove that when we convert it, which is what we're going to do now. So we're going to take that file, we're going to remove that first line, and then we do a conversion from that hex to binary. From that, we use the PL util to convert this information into an XML blob or XML file. And we rewrite that file to alice.plist. Plist utility allows you to convert information. And we're gonna convert this now into a plist file. And if you take a look at that file now, you can see we have all this interesting information now. And what we are looking for here is the salted SHA-512 PBKDF2, the hashing function. We have entropy, iterations, and salt. That's all we need. So I'm switching over to this other window here, where I'm just gonna create the file that the hashcat format. And the way it looks for Mac is it has an ML, a dollar, and then we have the iterations, and we're gonna put the salt, and then we can put the data. So iterations is very easy. We just go back here, copy the iterations out, put them in here, add a dollar sign for the next piece of information, which is this here. This now we have to convert because this is base64 encoded. So what I'm going to do, clear the screen here, echo that string, base64 decoded, and then we need to do, I think it's dash P. Let me take a look. Yeah, there's a trick. You can see how there's this line break. You can actually specify a higher number of columns so it all is in one line. So we copy that, put that in here. And then the last piece of information, if we now cut the ls.plist again, what we want is that up here. Now we do the same thing, we echo it. You can see we need to make it just one long line. Looks good. Now we base64 decode it, do our hex conversion. Oh, same thing, you can do the column 256. It's all just one long string that we can copy out here in that hex format. We paste it in here, and that was basically it. So we save the file. Now here, let's take a look at that file. Let me clear the screen before that hash. So this is now the format of Alice's password hash that we can pass into hashcat to crack it. Let's do that now. So we're just gonna run hashcat. And you can do help. And what I want to show you here is we grab from macOS, you can see the various modes that hashcat supports, and 7100 is what we are looking for. So we keep going. This is just a very simple example, so you can see 7100. So a dictionary attack, 7100 is the right mode. We need the hash, and then we need just our word list, I guess. And we kick that off. It's gonna run. And it successfully cracked the hash. Subscribe, and I'll see you next time.